On this episode,
we hope to keep the momentum from the last race and we want to carry it on.
When you start winning, everything except winning is not good.
Protect your inside. Come on, come on, come on.
He gave me a penalty.
You?
Yeah.
It's pretty much half the season's nearly done once you get through this weekend. It shows how important this weekend's going to be.
Focus. Hit your mark. Catch that guy.
We're battling our tails off.
We've been as quick as anyone, if not quicker, but had bad grid spots every day.
Four wide.
You can't get too comfortable.
This is Launch Control. Just outside of St. Louis, Missouri, the ARX Rallycross teams have arrived for their second stop on the calendar, a doubleheader event. It's possibly the most important weekend of the championship. For Subaru Motorsports USA, it arrives with part excitement and part reservation.
Big weekend, doubleheader, two races crammed into 2 days. It's very important to do well in both rounds and get some points going for the championship.
We hope to keep the momentum from the last race and we want to carry it on.
Just over 3 weeks earlier, at the opening race of the season,
3 seconds clear, this is the last lap.
This team's aspirations were realized. From a team that struggled to podium,
yeah, guys!
To their first victory in 5 years.
It's such a team win, and it really couldn't have gone much better.
As they celebrated, the realization set in.
This is for the Subaru fans following us every day. So here we go. Welcome to 2019.
They were no longer the underdogs, but rather the favorites. It's a change in fortune, but as they face a doubleheader weekend, there's no time to rest on their laurels.
It's pretty much half the season's nearly done once you get through this weekend, so you've got to be in a good position, and it shows how important this weekend's going to be.
Certainly very difficult on the mechanics. They're working 24/7 basically, because even if we have a clean heat, there's still stuff that comes in on the car that's a little bit banged up because the track's a bit rough and there's so much dirt out there. The boys are earning their money this weekend for sure.
I will just try to, in the first heat now I'm pole, I'm gonna just stay on my inside, hopefully no one is taking me out, and that's all I can do.
Day one, qualifier one, back to the grind. Three Subarus, now race proven, look to make their mark for the second event in a row. The first race features two Subarus and two champions. The Subarus get the jump off the line.
Three wide.
Tanner's there inside.
Atkinson's outside line is a disadvantage, but he lays down a strong time while Scott takes the win.
Checkered flag, well done.
Next, it's Sandell's turn, looking for redemption after a disappointing final at the first event. He's a man on a mission.
Protect your inside.
He dominates the second race of the session.
Nice work, Patrick. That's a win.
The Subarus sit first, second, and fourth after the first qualifying round. Their success seems to be continuing, and the team settles into the weekend. They know the job that has to be done. Build points in qualifying heats to earn a strong semifinal grid slot.
Fantastic to get a win in the first heat. Bring some self-confidence back since the last weekend. Very good to start like this when it's a doubleheader. There's so many points going out this weekend, so hopefully we will climb a few spots until Monday on the leaderboard.
We crushed them off the line, didn't want to risk too much. First, second, and fourth, about as good as we could do out of those draws, so that's we're pretty happy with that.
It's going to be a tough weekend. I mean, we're not as quick as we were at Mid-Ohio, so it makes our job tougher, but I mean, in Mid-Ohio, we were the fastest car there. We're not here. We're close. We're competitive. And now we just got to go out there and battle and fight with what we got.
Consistency and points in each heat will get them where they need to be.
Four wide, Tanner on your outside, still there.
That's when their biggest opponent falters.
This is last lap. Tanner's pulling off. You're clear behind. Tanner's out. Four wide.
Don't look back.
On your bumper.
Don't think about points. Just hammer down and capitalize on the opportunity.
To the checker.
By the end of the qualifying heats, two Subarus lead the way into the semifinals.
It's been an awesome day so far. Been P1, P2 more or less the whole day in my heats, and starting on pole in one of the semis, I couldn't ask for more. So it's kind of up to me to do a good start and hopefully then just take off.
It's been a funny day that we've been as quick as anyone, if not quicker, but had bad grid spots every day. We're just going to try and get on Scott's bumper and run some quick laps.
In semi-final one, it's a repeat of the last event.
Remember, if y'all start even, tuck right in there. Keep him outside.
The defending champion Scott Speed has dominated the leaderboard.
Careful now.
The semi-final is no different.
Clear. On your bumper.
Speed takes the win.
The checker.
Atkinson in third. Now it's up to Sandell to continue the trend.
Protect your inside. Come on. It's gonna be tight. Push now. Come on.
Sandell pushes in second, piling on the pressure. Arpin takes a wide entry, leaving the door open. Sandell pounces. Door-to-door contact, and he's through. A semi-final victory should put him on the front row for the final.
Fantastic work, Patrick.
Awesome.
With 10 minutes until the final, it's a scramble in the pits. All three cars are battered and bruised.
So grateful for Subaru and Vermont Sports Car that have been able to give us, you know, those cars now to be able to play in the front in every event. That's f***ing awesome. Sorry.
We're battling our tails off. The Beetle's really fast this weekend. We've taken good advantage of our qualifying draw. Yeah, hopefully we can pull off one more race win.
The cars head to the pre-grid, but Patrick has been assessed a penalty for his late race pass.
They gave him a penalty.
You?
Yeah. I have no idea.
Instead of a front row lockout, there's one Subaru on each row of the grid. Speed front row, Sandell middle, and Atkinson at the back. But all three have the inside line. Off the start, Speed defends his position.
Steer from behind.
Sandell rides his bumper. Atkinson tries to make it three, but Faust cuts across. It's a big hit. Faust retires, but the 55 Subaru stays on the attack.
Nice work, heading for the Joker.
At the front, Speed has lost the lead to Arpin.
Tanner broke, one back, half back, on your bumper.
Something's not right. Scott doesn't know it yet, but his car has a slow puncture. He pushes on, but the gap to the leader grows. Sandell opts to take his Joker lap, but he's lost time behind his ailing teammate. Now the team's best shot is Atkinson, who has recovered to lay down clean laps since the start. As Sandell exits the Joker, Atkinson is ahead.
You're P3 right now, P3.
Speed knows he's out of contention and lets his teammates pass to chase the leader.
You're P2. He has a flash. Focus. Catch that guy.
Atco and Sandell have already completed their Joker lap, so when Arpin emerges, they're right on his tail. Atkinson looks for a way past as the laps tick down.
Coming around to the checker. Get in there.
One corner left. Arpin enters the final corner wide for the second time in two races. And for the second time, a Subaru takes advantage. This time, there will be no penalty. Chris Atkinson will take his first ever Rallycross win.
Yeah!
Subaru's second victory in as many races, and a double podium with Sandell in third. A first for the team. They could get used to this.
Hey, what'd you say?
There you go. From the back row, like, you never think that could happen. It was just carnage, and it was a hard pass, but I want to win. Been with this team 3 years now, and it's been three fun years, but nothing's more fun than winning. Clean weekend.
It was patience, really. At the end of the day, literally, it was patience, and got it at the end. So you couldn't ask for more than that. Great result for the team.
First podium of the year, first double podium for Subaru. It's so good, so good. Thanks, Subaru.
The winner of the ARX of Gateway, Chris Atkinson.
Nobody expected such a quick turnaround of fortune. But every team member had a belief it was coming. And this weekend is only half complete. A late night of reprep, and they do it all over again in the morning.
We spent a number of years as the underdog. Everybody's uneasy because it happened again. We were competitive yesterday and actually won the event. You carry that with you, and you carry that drive with you, and the commitment to winning. You can't get too comfortable. These guys are passionate and driven, and they're not comfortable in this position, and I hope they never are. It's very nice to win, and you have to keep working at winning.
It almost sounds greedy. With another race day upon them, the drivers set their sights on a third victory.
Yeah, I got you.
There are three drivers on the team. Each of them have been on the podium. But their aspirations go beyond that early season victory. Those higher goals once felt like long shots, but now they're more real than ever before. They know the path to the top. Strategies can be executed. Win the launch. Control from the front. Never concede the inside line. And never look back. The team is still getting comfortable in their newfound position as favorites. But they know how to play the game.
Nice drive.
Tanner needs to get held up.
We're out in front of Bigham.
Going up on the front loses, he'll lose on the tarmac corner.
Good luck.
By the semifinal race, Scott leads the way, with Atkinson and Sandell in fourth and sixth, respectively. This places speed alone in the first semifinal.
Obviously an important semifinal coming up, but we've done a great job today to start from a really terrible qualifying draw and gain maximum points. That helps us a lot in the championship. Points is obviously what we're racing for, so it's of the highest priority, and I just always have that in my mind in every decision I take out on the racetrack.
With three opponents eager to dethrone the champ, speed will be under attack from all sides. He must win this launch. Speed holds his position on the inside. Faust has a nose ahead, but not a clean line. Speed fights to hold position, which opens the door for Arpin to sneak through.
On your bumper, bumper, bumper.
The attacks continue. Bigham pushes up the inside. The contact pushes Speed offline. He's gone from first to last in just a few seconds. On the same lap, Speed gets back in the mix when his competitors take the Joker lap.
Half back, on you.
He's up to third, but he needs to build a gap. on the last lap, Bingham jokers and Scott cuts inside. He fights back to finish in third place, enough to get him into the final, but on the back row.
Things go bad, you gotta keep your head on, you gotta drive smart.
Our plan is that whoever that is second of us, if we don't take the start, we take the joker on the first lap, and then hopefully we can move both cars up to the front.
Got to battle with Peacoy, try and beat him in that heat. If we can do that, then we'll be on the front row for the final, and hopefully we can have a win again.
Now, it's up to the other Subarus to claim a better starting grid position.
This side, this side.
All three cars race off the line.
Still there, still there. Drop in, get on the shoulder.
The Subarus aren't able to out-muscle Peacoy. It's going to come down to race strategy.
You got Patrick on your bumper now.
As Peacoy stays on the regular lap, Atkinson opts for the joker. Now, with clean air, the two Subarus set about reeling in the leader.
Come on, come on.
Sandell makes quick work of it.
Hit your marks, don't overdrive.
And when Peacoy attempts to stop Atkinson's progress, he spins out of the race. Both Subarus have done the work and finished 1-2 in the semifinal. Back at the pits, the team prepares for its third final of the year. It's been a hard-fought day, so the cars are more battered than they've been all year.
When you start to winning, everything except winning is not good, and we know we all three have the speed to win again today, so I'm so happy that we're finally here and we so deserve it.
It's the final race of the doubleheader weekend, and it carries serious importance in the championship hunt. 6 cars load into their final grid spots. One last launch for critical mid-season points.
Plan is for like the start, not taking any like crazy risks, and just take the joker early.
Off the start, Sandell leads the way with the inside line. Atco's launch propels him into second, but the outside line betrays him. Speed finds some room inside and makes a move to third. Atkinson then takes a hit and gets pushed out.
Go for the joker.
At the front, Sandell enjoys clean air and is making the most of it. He focuses on building a gap before taking the joker. In third, Speed reels in his ex-teammate. Behind him, Atkinson is also climbing back into the mix. Subarus sit first, third, and fourth. Speed watches the Volkswagen take the longer joker.
2.6 seconds back, come on. Push now.
And he comes out in front to inherit second place.
You're clear, you're clear, you're clear.
It's a 1-2 punch for Subaru with 2 corners left.
That is a P1.
First over the line, Patrick Sandell now takes his turn on the top step of the podium.
Thank you everybody so much.
Show them all how fun this is.
3 Subarus, 3 different winning drivers, 5 out of 9 podium positions filled with blue and gold.
This weekend has been absolutely insane. We did not expect to have 2 double podiums, 2 new winners. Now we've got 3 guys who each won an event, and we're 3 events into the season. The results have just been unbelievable to this point.
So 3 races, 3 winners, 3 Subaru winners. It's just amazing. You know what Vermont Sports Car and Subaru have done over the last couple of years, and especially this winter, it's just unreal, you know.
I told you this morning, what did I say?
So stoked for Patrick, he deserves this so much. He was so happy for me yesterday when I was on the podium, and that's what teammates are about. It's great to drive with him.
Patrick Sandell, winner of the ARX at Gateway.
This is the making of a season the Subaru community has dreamed of. Speed leads the championship, with two more Subarus tied for third in the points.
It just feels like the floodgates are opening and all that passion, all that excitement is finally coming out because everybody has waited so long for this. And it's just a blast to be a part of it for everybody that's in this paddock right now.
Subaru! Subaru! Subaru!
I want to thank everybody here, everybody out there, Subaru of America, all of our fans, our drivers, our engineers. Team in Northern U.S. taking on the big guys and getting it done. Thank you all. I love you all. Thank you. God. Free.
The ball is definitely rolling. The pressure is on to keep it moving.